Hello everyone, Nick Lecaudovine here playing Pro Cycling Manager 2016. We are about to go into stage 4, 5 and 6 of the Giro. Stage 4 is supposed to be hilly, so we should be able to have some fun there. We are in the first climb, first real climb in this tour, in this Giro. Quite a nice climb actually, and then gonna be another one, and then some smaller climbs towards the end, and the last climb is quite steep, so a lot of things could happen there. Quite a nice pace on the peloton, but nothing dangerous, nothing like some of the other tour stages that we have already been riding in this Giro. We are closing in on the 15 kilometers mark. National Bing decided to show themselves. I think they feel that Bardet would be in a great position to take yellow here. And then we see Latour trying the first attack from the peloton. Seems like he might be able to get away here. Another small climb, and then it's gonna take it easy for a few kilometers before the final climb. Latour have been caught. You see Menches pulling the peloton, and it seems like there might be a break here, but I do not think National Bing is going to allow that. There we go, everyone is back together again. Well, there's still the guy in the breakaway, but I do not think he will be able to hold on the last climb. And we are going into the final climb. I'm gonna up my effort to 85, because I do not want them to drop me here. Gonna keep an eye on the climb. It's going to be over soon, but then we see the first attack. Not the first attack, a big attack here, and I'm struggling. I cannot get up to speed. Some people have managed to get away. Amador is on my wheel. I managed to drop him. I'm moving past Landa. Oh, I need to catch up with these guys, but it's going to be difficult. Not much left to go. I'm starting the sprint. Can I close the gap? If I close the gap, I will ride in yellow. I'm quite sure of it. But this looks like it's going to be a little bit too much for me. Koenig? That's a surprise. Villarimos, Mentes, Latour, Rodriguez. Sixth place for me. So the summary of stage 4, we see that we came in 20 seconds behind, 27 seconds behind. All the other favorites had the same time as us, so we didn't get a gap there. And the general classification, this will be good to see. We are still 10 seconds behind. Stage 5, it's a flat stage. You can see there are some hills. There was a big climb in the beginning. Then there are some climbs here just after the middle point of the stage, but then it's downhill and mostly flat. So they think this will end in a sprint. I would like for the sprinters to not be with the peloton in the end, so I'm gonna see if I can remove at least some of them by telling my team to ride fast up the coming climbs here. It would be good for my own situation if we could drop some of the sprinters and maybe steal a victory for ourselves. We'll see if we can make it happen. Usually it doesn't work, not at this point in a long 21-day tour, but this is the Giro, so we need to try really hard to get any advantage we can get. So stage 5, 9th place, and Nothing changed in the general classification. Still in fourth place, 10 seconds behind, but that will probably change on the next stage. Stage 6. You can see there are some real mountains on this stage. First, we come to this one, a category 2 one. It looks like a tough climb. I'm gonna set my guys out to do some pacing. I do not have the whole team to order around. I would have liked that, but maybe they will come under my command later on. So this climb, I want to set a decent pace, not too high, not to tire my team out, but hopefully it will make some of the weaker climbers drop. And then after that, I am looking forward to this big climb. You can see it is a long last climb. It goes in a few different stages, so it should be very interesting. A real mountain stage today, and I feel like we are at least a top 10 climber in this group. If we are having a good day, we could do better than that. It depends on what the big names in this Giro wants to do. At least I'm setting my team out to do something, and I'm hoping for a smaller group that will take on most of the stage together, maybe 50 people. Some success, 91 people left in the main group, and we see that the red, blue, and white jersey are behind us. Not really sure what will happen, if they will catch up. Most likely they will. They will probably be working very hard to catch up as soon as possible, but that means that they will also struggle on the final climb. We see most of them caught up now, but I do not think it really matter. I think we did our job, tired some people out, and hopefully this means we will have a successful last half of the stage as well. 21 kilometers left. One of my teammates decided to attack. He completely drained himself very fast, so now he's just waiting for us to catch up with him. He doesn't have any energy left, so a strange tactics, but he can do whatever he wants, I guess. We are on the final climb now. This is a tough part, and it's going to be a little bit easier again until it starts to get really tough towards the end again. So at the moment we're just hanging on, waiting for other teams to do the hard work for us. We can see it is Astana that are trying to work hard at the moment. They have people like Micah and Yates, and that now Aru is attacking, but that attack is not going to hold. Aru just wasted some energy. Hopefully we are back to a fast pace again. This is the less difficult climb. We're just at 2 and 2.5% incline. Now it is starting to get tougher again. We still seem to be in decent conditioning. The pace is very high. You can see Aru is trying to attack again, and I think this time it is for real. We need to either chase him down or counter-attack. We are trying to chase him down a little bit, but I feel like we need to attack. And we got caught behind the National Bing riders. You can see Aru is getting away. I did not catch who else was with him. Was it Menches? Yeah, it Menches. Landa, we are going to pass Landa. Latour is following us. We are towards the end. We need to sprint. Aru is going to win. Menches is second place. Nibali in third place. then we might get the 8th place today. See what we will get. 9th place, no, 10th place. Ooh. Well, nothing to do. We see the brothers Simon Yates, Adam Yates. I think they are riding. Yeah, they are riding for different teams now. Two big talents, but they don't. Doesn't seem like they are good enough in this Giro. Fabio Aru, homeboy. No surprise there that he is the strongest. Final screen. Aru, Fabio Aru, and Luis Menchez. They got 25 seconds on the rest of us. And the general classification, Luis Menchez takes the lead. I am 25 seconds behind. Andre Amador, 1 second behind me. And Fabio Aru, 6 seconds behind me. Vincenzo Nibali, 16 seconds behind me. So we are still in it. We didn't take the pink jersey today. It would have been nice to at least get to ride in the pink jersey once. But this means we have the white jersey. 19 seconds ahead of Latour. And we can see Latour is actually quite strong. It's going to be difficult to fight with him for this jersey. But behind us, we have almost 2 minutes to Henao. Or Henao. So, it seems like it's going to be a two-person race for this jersey. And that will be the end of this episode. More Giro d'Italia in the next episode. Until then, I am Kill the Cow Divine. Thank you all for watching.